Tell them what we about to be talking about tonight. Hey, Patrice!
Hey!
Let them know what we're talking about tonight, Jason.
Yes.
Huh?
Let them know what we're talking about tonight.
Oh, in a few minutes, we're going to tell all the tax bros what they need to know on Stop Letting Their Mind to let them know how to showcase their greatness. We're going to unblock their mind.
Yes, it's time to unblock these minds. It's time to get rid of these mental blocks. Stop letting yourself be great from the mental blocks.
Right.
My name is Erica.
And I'm Jason.
And we've been in the tax industry for a little over 15 years now, and we are on a mission to mentor tax pros and be their accountability partner. Why do y'all need accountability partner? Because you need somebody to hold your hand and make sure that you are able to complete the tax in your tax business and make sure that you are able to take your tax business to the next level. So why not be with somebody that's been in the industry for over 15 years? So we're doing more than just teaching tax professionals how to file a tax return and how to submit clients. We created entrepreneurs over here and bosses. We helping them to take control of their future.
Yes, yes. I don't think they heard you though.
Not take control of their future.
But are you tired of playing small? Tell me who's tired of playing small.
Who's tired of playing small?
Are you ready to get in front of your ideal client? Your ideal client. I need to see something in this chat, man. Let me know.
Come on, y'all. What's some more mindset blocks?
Are you tired of not knowing what it would take for you to get your quality clients? Oh, come on. Oh, man, I guess they're a little shy right now.
Well, I'm Eric, and I'm from Atlanta.
I'm from Jersey City.
Yeah, where are y'all from? Y'all put where you from in the chat. Where y'all from? Y'all put where y'all from in the chat. Well, some of the mindset blocks that a lot of entrepreneurs face today is time management. You know, a lot of times time management will stop you from being able to... Jersey City, okay, Miss Jersey City? A lot of times your mindset will block you from achieving your goals as an entrepreneur. We help tax preparers turn themselves into tax pros by offering them CE courses so they can get credits from IRS. We help them scale their tax business. We help them deal with life and entrepreneurship. Because a lot of times having a consistent mindset, you have to have a mindset of gratitude. Do y'all know that? If you don't have a mindset of gratitude, then you're going to be a negative Nancy. So we help our clients overcome not having basic tax knowledge. We help them to get like over 23 courses of training and basic income tax courses. They get their AFSP certificate of completion. And this helped them boost their confidence because now they're going to have the knowledge that to be a tax professional. And now they can file taxes with confidence. How are you going to file taxes and you don't have the knowledge behind it? So your business is personal. It's a part of your vision and your mission, and you've invested in it. So we help you build up your mental frustrations. We help you build your teams, your systems, your workflow. Why? Because it takes time. It's not overnight. It is not overnight.
Definitely.
So click the link in the bio to learn more about how we can help you gather leads and create content that's going to convert and help you get a more clear message out across to your ideal client. Yes, Brittany, confidence.
Hey.
So, Jason, tell them what we introduce our speaker today.
I would like to introduce the lovely Miss Patrice Johnson.
Hey, Patrice.
She is here to help you get your mind unstuck. So, Miss Patrice Johnson, tell us a little bit about yourself, please.
OMG, I'm excited about doing that. This is just so awesome, y'all. Like, this is good. you don't know people who just come in and they just talk. They give the meat and potatoes in reference to taxes. We're just looking at the numbers, right? Most people just deal with the numbers. But you all, I'm excited to be here because I am Patrice D. Johnson, CEO and founder of Be Magnetizing from
the state of Mississippi, okay? I'm the Magnetized Money Coach, and I help entrepreneurs to actually become a money magnet. And a lot of things are involved in that happening. And the first thing that has to happen is actually understanding the mindset to create wealth. Huh. So that's what I'm here for.
So
give us like a little brief. You know, I heard you say you're from Mississippi. Are everything okay down there?
Yes.
With the water?
Yes, we're making it, okay? It's not something that's going to go away overnight.
Right.
Something that's going to take some time.
But we're definitely. Well, our prayers are going out to you all, because that could be any of us. You know, like we, right. I lived in New Orleans for 15 years. I experienced Hurricane Katrina, so I know what it means for a city to shut down. And, you know, your main natural resource of water, you're not having that. So our prayers really go out to you. They go out to you. All to y'all. So today I want to talk about how you can help these entrepreneurs get their mindset unstuck. So what are the key elements of releasing the scarcity mindset?
First of all, you got to understand that there are four key components in any successful business. And you mentioned one of them. One of them is understanding the importance of time management is one. Okay. Time management will definitely get a lot of us stuck, because time gets away from a lot of people if you're really not logging it, right? And the second thing is definitely it's people skills. Understanding how to communicate with people. Okay.
Y'all better take notes.
That is one of the main ingredients. Another one, and this is emotional management. Emotional management. Okay. When you're running a business, it's not about your emotions, sister, bro. Okay. It is not about that.
Take it out.
Right. It's not about your emotions. The only emotions that matter when it comes to you and your consumer is your consumer. Okay. Those are only emotions that you need to be concerned about. And then last and not least, but it's the financial management. Okay.
Say it again.
Financial management.
One more time for the people in the back.
What? Come on. Say it louder.
Management, okay? Go and help somebody else in their finances, and you are... Hello, somebody. Okay. Right?
So, why are you running a business if you're not profiting?
Okay.
Yeah. What you sacrificing? You sacrificing to lose, or you sacrificing to profit and create what generational wealth?
That's it. Most definitely. That's it. And you know, I'm going to tell you a lot of the situation that happens though, Erica, is that people have a blueprint in their life that they don't realize that they got to work through. And it's the blueprint is your mind. Mm-hmm. And okay. Your mind.
Look, you hitting them. I'm feeling it. I'm feeling all of them. Yeah.
Talk to them.
Yes. The blueprint is your mind. And so a lot of times people, they're not thinking about, like, you find yourself in a cycle, there's a reason for that cycle. If you find yourself doing the same thing over and over again, there's a reason for that. And what's important is to figure out what that blueprint is.
Yes, ma'am. So those are the key elements of releasing that scarcity mindset. So now tell us, how does the mindset play a part in how entrepreneurs make decisions?
Oh, you just said it. You got to decide. And how are you going to make a decision and not think, right? Thinking, okay, y'all know the word. I'm not here to preach for you, but it says, so is
preach,
a man.
Preach.
Look, so is a man thinking, so is he. So what are you thinking?
I know you got that.
Say one more time.
Let's go.
Right. So what are you thinking? Like, what are you thinking? That is impacting everything that you're doing. Okay. That's why I said that money, your mindset, you know, I'm stuck on money, but mindset is the blueprint, okay? Mindset is your blueprint, because that is actually going to tell you how you're operating. It affects and impacts everything that you're doing.
Yes.
Yeah.
See, what people don't understand, when they start a business, you know, they think it's all about, okay, hey, everybody, I'm a tax preparer. You know, here's my logo. But if your mind isn't right, are you really running your business correctly? If your mindset isn't right, whenever you go over any stumbling block, guess what? You're going to crash. So you got to start out. You got to get your mindset. We talked about the brand the other day. You got to get that brand. That's your foundation. But you had to get that mindset together. If your mindset not right, you're not, I'm telling you, business is not, you got to get that mindset together.
You know,
so how can entrepreneurs escape blocks, mindset blocks? Who? They're blocking themselves from being great.
Okay, first of all, this is you were speaking on this as well. You've got to have, you know, the word says where two or three gather, he's there, right? You got to touch.
Yes, ma'am.
You got to touch and agree. And so oftentimes if you find the word is totally a guide. So if you look in the word, oftentimes it's not just somebody by themselves. When there's accountability, you have to have another person in the place. So you need somebody to be able to bounce your ideas off of. You need somebody to be able to just ask some questions to talk to. Because guess what? Two heads are better than one. So it's important. I like to say this. I have a layout that's called IAC. Is about the coach, and that's what it's about. In order for you to go and coach somebody, you got to be coachable yourself. Okay.
Oh my God.
That was right there.
You gotta be able to take constructive criticism. You gotta be able to listen. How are you gonna coach somebody and you can't even listen to somebody giving you constructive criticism and trying to help you?
Correct. You've got to be coachable. And so in order for you to be coachable, that's gonna be a good coach. Every coach needs a coach.
Yes. Every coach needs a coach. So do you have anything else? Do you have anything else? Any more gems for our entrepreneurs out here?
Girl, look, I'm just getting started.
Let's go.
Go ahead.
Look, We got time today.
Okay, good, because this is something as well. You know, people, I remember somebody said this to me one time before when working with them. Does it take all of this? Does it take all of these, the peeling layers? Because we've got to figure out what the holdup is.
Right.
We have to figure out what's causing you not to move forward. Okay. And the key component is who you're being. It is who you're being. See, who you're being is a result of what you're thinking. That is your mind, right? And so if that is impacted, then everything else is going to be shifted. Everything else is going to be impacted.
Yes.
So find out what that is. So I like to call it, the first thing, it's about mind. M is for your matter. So you got to
acronyms.
You got to find out what the matter is. Whether the matter is you're stuck with running your business financially. You're stuck with as it relates to your payroll, right? You're stuck with as it relates to just your systems. Whatever it is what the matter is, you got to first acknowledge what the matter is. The second thing you got is in mind. What's the second letter? I.
I.
Put the finger back at you. Are you the problem? Okay.
Terrible.
Yeah, you got to think about like. Are you the problem? A leader always, a business owner always evaluates themselves. Okay. They always must evaluate who they are, what they're doing, and how they are operating, how they are presenting. I heard you all talk about like wearing your brand. What are you? Are you representing?
Wear your brand. Woo. All day, every day.
And let me tell you why that is. It's because you representing you help people to identify who you are when you show up. And so what does that do? It puts a crease of you in their brain every time they see you. Mm-hmm. Who are you being? That's what the I is, right? And then I've got to tell you, baby, about the end.
Tell us about the end.
Okay. About now. No more delaying, no more trying to figure, no more putting it off, no more procrastinating. You got to go ahead and do it right now. Whatever it is. Yes, whatever it is you got to shift in your business, you got to do it now. Whatever you got to get unstuck about, you got to address it now. It's not going to go away. All right? And then D is for dominate.
Wait, say it one more time. No, seriously. That's my word, okay? Come on, preach.
You have to dominate it. You dominate your mind. You got to dominate you, and you got to dominate your time.
Woo!
Okay? Because that is the only way, you all, that you're going to be able to get yourself unstuck and to work on your mindset as it relates to you, your business, and everything else. And most people, Erica, they really, and I'm going to tell you, Jones, I know you're here. I know you hear Jones, okay? But I'm going to tell you this. Most people, they really discredit the importance of understanding what this is about. Because this, without this, how are you operating? Cut the head off. The body is nothing.
Right.
So if your head game ain't right, right?
Nothing. Do y'all hear her? Look, y'all, I hope y'all taking notes. I hope y'all taking notes. I hope y'all taking notes.
Okay. That's it. And you're talking about how to get your mind unstuck. And I'm going to say this. Thank you. Somebody just put in a chat, mindset. Yes, it is. Let me tell you this. This is how I like to look at the words mindset. I think that people, they automatically put mindset together.
Right.
And I think it should be separated. Okay. That's what I teach. It should be separated. Because why it should be separated? Because your mind is set on something. So if you look at it as a conjunction, it doesn't mean the same thing as two separate words. So mindset, right?
Right. That's a
compound. But when you say, what is my mind set on? That is a now, then, causing an action. Set becomes an action instead of part of a noun. So then when you're looking at your mindset, it causes your mind to take action.
Mm-hmm. When I asked her to drop some gems, y'all, I know she was gonna drop it like that. I know she was gonna come with the heat like that, Lord. I'm scared to ask you got more. This lady powerful. Told y'all we not playing. This a mindset guru. Do y'all got any questions for Miss Patrice? We've got a couple minutes. Do y'all have any more questions for? Y'all better look. Access ain't easy. Y'all got access to her right now. Y'all better ask her questions. She looking at the chat.
Come on, drop that.
She said, make your mind move. That's it.
Yes.
Mind move.
Michelle keep dropping them dimes. I see her in there. She keep dropping them gems in the chat. Michelle on fire. Y'all got any questions for any of us? I know Geronda. Woo, girl. She coming with it. Well, if y'all don't have any questions, you know, make sure y'all click the link in our bio to let us help you become unstuck and start making money. That's what it's about. Why are you an entrepreneur? Is it a hobby or is it a business? If you rather turn your passion into profit and turn your passion into a profitable business, click the link in our bio. Click the link in our bio. We are here to help. Y'all got any questions, any of us? Okay, y'all. Miss Patrice, thank you so much for blessing us with your presence, y'all. It's just the beginning. That's all I'm gonna tell y'all. Y'all gonna see Brandy again. You're gonna see Patrice again. And tomorrow we got Miss She Prince on the ones and twos. She gonna talk about your message. Man, look, y'all, make sure y'all on tomorrow at 7:00. Y'all thought it's just getting warmer and warmer, okay?
Wait, hold on.
Brittany, she said, how do you gain your confidence when you're face-to-face with your clients?
Okay, that's good. Okay, how do you gain your confidence when you're face-to-face with your clients?
Thank you, Brittany.
That has everything to do with who you're being, okay? Because you got to know what you know before you get in front of your client. You got to know what you know. You got to know, and I believe I heard you say this, Erica. I don't know if it was in some of your material or something, but see, you got to be clear about what you bring to the table. Okay, so do you know?
And confident. You got to be confident about what you bring to the table.
I'm going
to
tell you that, and that can be a beast. That's another mindset thing.
Right.
Okay, I'm a deliverer of that. So let me tell you, that comes with you knowing what you bring to the table. Okay. Yes. That's why when I say be magnetized money, it is your being. Hmm. It is walk in the room who you be. I mean, it is you being clear about what it is you do and what you have to offer. And you got to be clear about this. Everybody don't need you.
All money not good money. Okay, you have to set the standards. You got to set the standards for your tax business. That's right. Your business. So you have your client interview sheet already in front of you. So you know how you're going to come at them. You set the standards. You send them all their documents before you even meet with them. You go ahead and send them their interview, their checklist of what you need, all the documents you need. Make them send them to you before your appointment. Why? So you can be ready. So you can know what they don't have. You can know where they're coming from. And number one, you can know if you want to deal with them. Right. Why? Because this is your tax business. And you set the standards. You set the tone. All money's not good money. So if you already send them the client interview and you send them, you know, everything you need from them, and they don't even have it, or they playing, you know, they trying to run scams, guess what? You know that's not your avatar, because you want quality clients. So guess what? That's one way you deal with your clients. You set the tone in the beginning. You let them know what you need from them. And that'll make it easier for that first face-to-face interaction with them. Somebody said, how they connect. Yeah, I'm telling you. Somebody said how they connect with Patrice. How to connect with you, Patrice?
Yes, you can definitely. I am right here on Instagram. You can DM me at Patrice D. Johnson, okay? You can also find me on Facebook called Be Magnetized Money.
Right? Say it again. This lady not playing about that financial literacy. Tell them about your challenge coming up.
Oh, yes, indeed. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Happening September 21st, baby. You want to be in the class. It's a free class I'm offering. And the title of the class is called See the Money. That's important, y'all. You got to see the money. It's more than just
the money.
More than just your eyes. So it's going to be a 3-day challenge that's going to be involved. I'm going to have my VIPs in the room. It's going to be amazing. It's going to be intense. And guess what? I'm magnetic. So before I'm done with you, you will be too.
And if y'all want to unstuck your tax business all together, click our link in our bio so we can go ahead and get. Guess what? Tax season is around the corner, y'all. Q4 is coming next month. Why wait that late? You can start now. We can start now. Okay? Click a link in our bio so you can go ahead and get your tax business unstuck ASAP. Don't wait until December. Do not wait until December to get your tax business in order. Get it together now. So on Wednesday, we're going to teach you how to get your mind unstuck, how to get your message unstuck, how to get your brand unstuck, how to get your money unstuck. It's time, y'all. Do y'all know what a USP is? If you don't, you need to be in the room on Wednesday. Click the link in our bio. We're going to help y'all get y'all tax business unstuck. And Miss Patrice going to help you get everything else unstuck. You're going to get that money together, get your mind so you can be ready.